book and the Grand Plan Project by Cynthia Lady Rose Roberson. Rita Book attempted to tiptoe through the living room without disturbing her mother napping on the couch. When her cell phone rang, Rita tripped, fell, and screamed, "Ouch!" Her mother woke up with a loud shout yelling, "Get out!" When Rita Book finally answered her phone, it was Miss Celeste, the neighborhood media specialist. She worked at the local library, where Rita Book, her big brother Rodney, and their friends hung out after school. They even had their own special room. At the library, they had formed the Rita Book Book Club. This made the library a great place to be. What made it even better, Miss Celeste would give out their favorite treats. When Rita Book and her book club crew arrived at the library and entered in, Miss Celeste stood to greet them with a great big wide grin. "Rita, I have an amazing idea," she said with pure delight. Rita said, "What is it?" wondering in hindsight. All Rita knew was that the last time that Miss Celeste was overtaken with glee, Miss Celeste almost caused a catastrophe. Go ahead and spill the beans, Miss C," Rita said with a laugh. Miss Celeste smiled with a smirk and told them to close their eyes and open up their hands. Rodney, he looked confused. "Hey, what's the grand plan?" The Rita Book Club began to ask why. Miss Celeste said, "Just do it and you'll soon realize." Rita Book's heart was filled with suspense. What was Miss Celeste up to? It made no sense. Next thing you know, something cold and wet slid down into their palm. Everyone laughed. They were caught completely off guard. "What's this? What does this have to do with the amazing idea?" Everyone was confused. Miss Celeste just stared at them and looked down at her shoes. She laughed out loud as if she had heard the funniest joke. They just stood there baffled, unsure what to do. Next thing you know, they began laughing too. "What's the amazing idea?" Rita Book inquired. "What are you up to?" Rodney asked, "Can you give us a clue?" "Well," said Miss Celeste, "I heard on the news that something is going around that feels like the flu." "The flu? The flu?" everyone asked. "Do you know how long this flu will last?" "I don't know," she said. "I'm really not sure. All I know is that the schools are closing and we'll have to stay indoors." "Indoors?" Rita Book and her friends were appalled. Then Rodney asked, "Does this mean we can't hang out at the mall?" Miss Celeste told them not to worry and not to fret. She came up with an idea that they would never forget. She said, "As a book club, Grand Plan Project, I want you to create slogans on posters that will help motivate. Motivate your peers and your families too, to take this flu seriously. The doctors don't even know what to do." So Rita Book and her crew jumped at the chance to inform their community according to Mrs. Celeste's great grand plan. In order to give an explanation, Rodney launched an investigation. He learned about the virus that felt like the flu, and he shared the information with everyone he knew. He informed us that it's called the coronavirus, also known as COVID-19. People are getting sick and dying in ways the world has never seen. This coronavirus, this COVID-19 thing, will force everyone to stay in their home, quarantine. Miss Celeste told Rita Book and her book club crew that she would provide everything they need so that their efforts would succeed. This would mean that Rita Book would have to be as creative as she could possibly be. The gang was determined to make sure that the goal would be achieved. Miss Celeste said, I'm sensing that our time from school may be long and sitting home with idle minds is just simply wrong. So Miss Celeste, she shared her vision and the Read a Book Book Club fulfilled the commission, making the Grand Plan Project their number one mission. Read a Book and her club crew made known lots of information just before that unexpected vacation. Here's some of the things that they all shared so that everyone could begin to plan and be prepared. They impressed upon their schoolmates that learning should never stop and to make sure that literacy held a priority spot. They told them to create a schedule that they could stick to and to do some schoolwork offline or virtual. They said, try not to spend your days just watching lots of TV. Build up your mental muscles. Feed your need to read. They stressed that they should do all of the assignments their teachers assign, all of the worksheets and workbooks of various kinds. And don't forget to keep your hands nice and clean. Don't forget to practice social distancing. Stand back from people at least 6 feet. Just smile and nod to anyone you greet. In your PJs or out of your flannels, make sure you tune into the Read a Book Book Club YouTube channel. Miss Celeste was so happy. Miss Celeste was very pleased. Everyone gathered their things as they prepared to leave. Rita Book, Rodney, and their friends really didn't want the moment to end. But once they realized they had no more time, they all agreed, let's start a group chat. We can meet up online. Miss Celeste responded, that'll be just fine. But whatever you do, make sure you sanitize.